Hello, future millionaires, and welcome back to my channel. I am Kayla K. Keen, and in this video, I'll be teaching you how to use PayPal, whether online or the mobile app. The first step in using PayPal is to type in PAYPAL on your desktop or on your mobile device. Once you have done that, you'll go to a page that has you signing up for a business or a personal account. So if you are not sure if you want to use a business account just yet, choose personal, because you can switch to a business account at a later date. Furthermore, the business account does come at a small cost. So let's do the personal account first, and then in the end I'll show you how to change over from a personal account to a business account. So once you have done that, it will take you to this page. Once you click next, that will ask you for your bio data. So you will type in your legal first, last name, your email address, and then you're going to create a password for your account and confirm the password by just typing it in the other slot so that they can confirm that that is indeed the password that you want to use. Unlike some other apps where you are allowed to use some pseudonym, you can't do that. So once you do that, you click next, and it will ask you for your mailing information. And then it will also ask for your debit or credit card number and the expiry date so that they can link your bank account to your PayPal account, so that when money is paid over to your PayPal account, you can transfer it over to your regular bank account, which will allow you, of course, to spend the money. So if you click right here at the bottom that says receiving money, you can actually send a request to anyone who wants to send you money. Yes, so if you want to send them your PayPal link, then you can go ahead and click there and send the link to them. The summary page, activity page, send and request, wallet and shopping are all the tabs at the top. So of course, if you click on them, they will tell you more about those tabs. Another very important feature of the PayPal app is the link your bank feature. And of course, this feature allows you to link a bank account to your PayPal, so whenever money is sent to your PayPal account, you can transfer over that money to your bank account so that you'll be able to use it when you need it. Additionally, if you link your credit card, that's also an option where you can transfer the money so that you can actually spend this money. So if you click on this link, it will take you to your PayPal balance. Of course, this is not my account, this is just a setup one, just to show you how it is used. So it will show you your PayPal balance. That's your PayPal balance right there. And if you look underneath it, you see a little button that says transfer money. So you can hit the transfer money to transfer whether money to your account, to someone else's account, or to your card that you would have added earlier to your PayPal account. Remember that PayPal is a digital wallet, so if you don't transfer the money, it's going to sit there forever, right? So you want to transfer the money out. You don't want to just have the money sitting there, of course, unless you're not ready for it. So we're going to hit those three little buttons, and I'm going to do a quick demo for you of the option. So it says add money. Once you click that, you can select the name of the bank account that is already attached to the account, type in the amount, and you follow the instructions. There are no fees associated to adding money to your bank account. So yes, this option allows you to send money from your PayPal account to your bank account without paying anything. So if you choose to do that, when you come back to this page, the summary page, it will show you just below there where you can see the cursor is at. It will show you all your activities, so you know exactly what happened to your money. So as you can see on this side, there are also options to send, request, and so on. So as I was telling you before, you can ask persons to send you money too. Now this is your wallet. So the wallet, in the wallet you can link a debit card or a credit card, and you can link a bank account. So if you don't already have that, you can go ahead and go into this section to do that. So we're just going to hit that link, and it shows you all the banks that you can link there. For those of you who are watching in Jamaica, have no fear, you can indeed link your Jamaican accounts to your PayPal wallet. When I initially signed up, I saw a charge of 140 something dollars that was taken from my account, $1 US, the equivalent. My bank, however, refunded the money. So let's go ahead and link a card now. So you can link a debit or credit card, Chase, American Express, there are lots of options. So once you hit that, it will just ask you for your debit or credit card information and all of the associated details. So once you do that, you can link your cards to your PayPal account. All right, for those of you who are living outside of the US, this is an important feature for you. This is a currency calculator. So for example, if somebody is sending you money from the US, say you have a small business and they're paying for a service and the service is 3,000 Jamaican dollars, then you can use your currency calculator to find out the amount of money that you need to send. So this is how you transfer money. Once you hit the transfer icon, you can request a check by mail or you can transfer to your bank, right? You can also add money to your balance. So this both shows you how to add money and how to take out money. All right, so this is how you send and request money. You just simply type in the name, email, or phone number of the person's PayPal account. And once you do that, you can continue to follow the steps. Once information is typed in, the box below will light up and allow you to complete that transaction. So PayPal is actually very easy to use. I know that a lot of persons, especially here in Jamaica, are scared of using it, but this is how it is used. So for example, we want to send somebody $100. You type in the 100, you pick your currency, and you can select this option that says pay for item or service. You can go back in and fix the figure if you want or whatever. Click change. So PayPal will ask you for some additional information as it relates to the purpose of sending the funds, whether it is that you're sending the funds to a friend or on the bottom to a business place. It doesn't cost you any money to send money to the business, however the business will have to pay a small amount when they receive the money. So let's select the option of friend here. So you just go ahead and double check your figures, and then once you are settled on which of the options to choose, you will go ahead and select. Remember also that there is an option to request money, so let's look at that. So once you click request, you can request money from anyone who also has a PayPal account. Once you have their name or their email address or their telephone number, so you can type in the amount. Say for example, I wanted $10 from somebody. Select your currency. We're going to use US for the purpose of the demo, and then you would add in the person that you want the money from, right? You can also split a bill with someone. So if you were paying for something, say you and I were paying for something and it's 100 US, you wanted me to pay 50 and you pay 50, then yes, you can also do that. So to send the request, you would type in the person's information and then you will send it off. As it relates to your activity tab, this tells you all of your transaction. You can set the dates as the parameters for when you want to see your transaction for. So say if it was this month, you'd only type in the first date to the last date in the month, and then it will tell you shopping now. So this also gives you deals. It tells you where you can get gift cards from. Let's click on one to see what will happen. So if you have a balance on your account, you could use it to purchase gift cards. All right, so that's the setting tabs that we're in now. And in this tab, you can change all of your personal information. You can add a photo to your profile or upgrade any information, update any information that you want to update. For example, your email address, your home address, and so on. Remember I said earlier in the video that you can create a personal account and then switch to a business account. So I'll be doing a demo of that. If you see that little option there, you can click it to switch to a business account. So I'm now inside of a business account, and let's talk about how that works. So the first thing you're going to notice is that the tabs at the top are a little different. You have activity, reports, tools, your summaries over the first part. You still have your same settings, but they're a little different in terms of layout. So as you can see, you can transfer money, you can still add money. Under the transfer money, it can be instant transfer, standard transfer, you can do check by mail. And then it shows you your recent activities there on your home screen. So if you click that, of course, you'll see all of the transactions that you have done. You can get paid faster. This is one of the good thing about the business account. It allows you to send a professional money request to persons who you might have provided goods or service for. So if you click the money tab, it will have some similar options to the personal account, like your bank account, your credit card, your balance, your currency calculator, sending and receiving money. So if you click sending and receiving money, you'll see that it still has a send request, contacts, more options similar to the personal account. You can put in a name, email address, or number to send or request money, similar to the personal account. So as I said before, although the setup is a little different, it's basically the same thing. The only option that is here that is not on the personal account is the fact that it allows you to send professional invoice. So here you can see you can create an invoice by simply adding your logo, adding all of the billing information. This is really professional. And then you can, of course, review and send it off to your customers. Remember to like the video, share it with a friend, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss another update. This is all for now, but until next time, stay financially literate.